Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU China. I'm Henry. It has been 5 months after I first printed my 3D motor. I have printed a lot of motors and designed a lot of motors. I have learned a lot from former designers and make my own original designs. I designed motors not just only simply copy former artworks. Most of them have my original unique idea inside them. Now it is time to compilation my designs, which I feel still have value to use. All motors can be downloaded from Thingiverse for free under my name. And the detailed explained videos are catalogued in my channel. Stick around. Let's start. Number 1. Back clip. I have inspired by this design from Thingiverse. I modified the triangle shape to a round shape. It will increase the contact area with the bag, which gets better sear result. And add a little longer item for recent usage. Now they are 50mm, 80mm, 120mm, and 160mm long respectively. Here we are! The sear result is very promising. I think it is better than the old version. Number 2. Test plate for your 3D printer. It is simple, yet it can test the performance of your 3D printer easily. I think it still has value if you have a new printer in hand. Fortunately, my 3D printer Anycubic is quite good in this test. Number 3. How to calibrate 3D printed thread for direct use. This is also a simple test to calibrate your 3D printer tolerance or clearance. You should know that what is your printer's capability. You always want to know how to connect your 3D printed thread with normal screws or bolts. It will give you clear information about how precise this of your printer is. Now I have found my 3D printer has about 0.2mm tolerance. It is quite good as a cheap printer. I can directly connect the screws to my printed thread after adding a -0.08mm press pull value to the thread without any modification. I also learned how to use historical recording in Fusion 360. It is very powerful tool to modify your printing parameters when you do a similar design. Unfortunately, my old computer freezes several times because the hardware is not good enough. I made it about 6 years ago myself. Now I use direct motoring and work quite smooth without any problem. Number 4. Tripod connector. It is a simple universe connector, connect your camera to a normal tripod. I have learned that there are two major different measuring systems, the SI system and the imperial unit. You should know that the length is really in millimeter or inch in your design. Otherwise, it may cause some problems in critical condition. In tripod connector, usually it uses an imperial unit. The connector thread and the screws are 1/4 inch in a small tripod. It is 6.35mm in SI unit system. The normal M6 screw is not good for this situation. Number 5. DIY safety gun drill using 1.5V DC motor. It is a new start using DC 130 motor to make tools. I have learned how to align the sketch with image, and also make connector shaft which has a different diameter. Also, I have learned that the preciseness will interfere with the final result. If the shaft drifts a little, the final drill will not work in good condition. Number 6. How to DIY multifunctional cutting tool using a 3D printer. I designed a multifunctional cutting knife. It can cut the wire and work as a wire striper. Of course, it works as a normal cutting knife as well. I have learned the wire is catalogued using AWG format and the safety protocol when using wire. You should take care of the working power, otherwise the wire problem is very serious. Number 7. Upgrade version of multifunctional cutting blade and wire striper with safety lock. It is an upgraded version of the above cutting knife. It uses a simple concept which does not need to consider the AWG format at all. It works as a cutting tool and a wire stripper with a safety lock. Can be used as a cutter, and a wire stripper from AWG-36 to AWG-6 easily. Safety lock can prevent the small kids from accidentally open the cutter and cause hurt. Number 8. Make longest homemade flexible shaft in the world using a stainless steel wire. I designed a very long shaft which can be used in a flexible condition. I have a new idea of how to improve it, but recently I have no desire to use flexible tools. I will open the project again if it is necessary. Number 9. Small toolkit for making incredible antigravity table. I designed the small toolkit making a shoe table very easy. You will learn the physical principles through a simple, clear explanation. If you want to learn science, you should follow me and subscribe to the channel. I always explain the detailed information on how to design the motor, what is important and where is the key point, and how to solve the problem with simple methods. Number 10. DIY hair cutter using a 3D printer. I designed a simple hair cutter. It can work in principle, but you always need help from others. Otherwise, it is difficult to handle. I have learned that the principle is correct, but in the real world, it may not be as good as you expected. You should always do it yourself, otherwise you will not learn the real meaning of a real subject. Number 11. DIY hair cutter using a 3D printer improved. Of course, I designed an upgraded version which you can really cut your hair by yourself. I used a new concept to cut hair which has not yet been used by anyone else as I know. Use of the shaving blade and rotator type is new in this design. If you want to do the same work use another method, you should follow me and subscribe to the channel. I always try to use another method and try a new idea to fulfill the quest. Number 12. DIY portable hair cutter and multifunctional toolkit using a 3D printer all-in-one. This is also an upgraded version of hair cutter, and it can do much more like a multifunctional tool. Number 1. Working as a drill. It is an additional option. It can work in a counterclockwise direction. Number 2. Working as a grinding machine. Number 3. Working as a cutting machine. Number 4. Working as other machines such as... Number 5. Working as a fan. Number 6. Working as a vacuum cleaner. I always try doing things in an easy and more functional way. Number 13. Cable tie unlock. I have learned how to unlock a cable tie through the internet. Now I designed this simple item to make it easy to use and safe. Number 14. DIY complete homemade AA battery case, expandable, failsafe. I designed this AA battery case, which can be expanded very easy. The electrode also completely homemade. It also has a failsafe function. Number 15. DIY normal ball bearing and a special high structure rod waterproof bearing using a 3D printer. This is a new try making a small tool. The concept can be used for your design which implants the ball bearing in the item itself. I have used this method in other design later. Number 16. How to make a good water pump? All you should know about the water pump made by mini DC motor. This is inspired by a lot of homemade water pumps through YouTube videos. Most of them are quite simple, since they are the combination of motor and a rotator impeller fan. They did not consider efficiency, safety, etc. I have learned which motor is suitable in some case. What battery is good in some condition. You should always keep in mind a lot of parameters can change the final results. If you are interested in detailed information, you definitely should follow me and subscribe to my channel. I will do the laboratory work and share the results with you, so you can focus on the most exciting part you are interested in. Number 17. I washed my Toyota Prius with 8-liter water. This is an application use a water pump. I designed some accessory to water the plant and wash my car. I have learned how to change the STL file to a mesh file. Then you can modify it. And how to use an ergonomic part in your design. In fact, it is quite like sculpting with Blender in Fusion 360. Number 18. How to make a simple juice mixer used in the bottle directly using a mini DC motor and a 3D printer. This is a simple juice mixer which uses a mini DC motor. But the idea is quite new and unique since no one considers mixed juice directly in the bottle. I always try seeing the world with another angle and making things different. Number 19. How to make extendable gearbox with ball bearing embedded. This is a ball bearing embedded gearbox. Also, it can be extended to your desired gear ratio. The limitation is the length of the screws and maybe your imagination. I have learned that the symmetry is beautiful and how it will be easy to expand the whole stuff using simple repeat unit. Number 20. DIY self-extendable gearbox upgrade version. Again, I have found an easier and more convenient upgrade version as usual. It is completely extendable since you will not need a screw to add a new repeat unit. When I concentrated on something, I can think deeper and find the insight of the subject. Now it's your choice to follow me and subscribe to my channel and support me. The like button is not that difficult, and it will give me more energy to move forward. Stay positive and creative. Thank you. Number 21, DIY dynamometer, friction torque meter using a 3D printer. I designed this friction torque meter to study the performance of the motor, gearbox, and other stuff. It is also a dynamometer to measure the torque and the rotation speed, RPM, simultaneously for motor or rotation nozzle engine. Number 22. How to select the motor and the gearbox. The secret of the torque and the speed. I do a lot of experiments and explain the real meaning of speed and torque. Through the experimental results, I reveal the secret of the torque and the speed. I have learned how to select the motor and the gearbox in real life. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. You will not regret your choice. Also, leave your comments so we can know each other. I'm looking forward to seeing you soon again. Hope you have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, click on the small bell so you will not miss the update. TubeU channel is waiting for you.